Miss Amanda, and we're going to continue our study today on the Ten Commandments. We've been talking about the Ten Commandments using road signs, and that's because road signs, they're used to help you know what direction to go, and in the same way, God uses the Ten Commandments to help us know what choices to make in life. So our first road sign is First Street. First Street just helps us to remember to keep God first in our life. Real God Road. We don't worship any idols or anything other than the one true God. Name Lane. We don't misuse God's name or say it in a disrespectful way. Sabbath Street. We have a special day set aside where we focus a little bit more on prayer and worshiping God. Parent Parkway. We honor our parents and show them love in that way by showing them respect. No Pain Lane. This is what we talked about last week. We don't hurt others. And Giving Boulevard. That's what our 10th commandment is today, what this is based off of, and that's we don't steal. And that's what our big idea is today. And that's based off of Exodus 20:15. We'll look there now. If you want to go in your Bible with me to Exodus 20:15, and it simply is, you must not steal. So we're going to talk a little bit more about that today, that concept, and I really wish that I could call some of you and ask you some of these questions and bring you into the conversation, but I just don't know how we might do that. Wait, I have an idea.
As we talk about stealing in our lesson today, let's try to get some input from some of our Lighthouse Kid friends. And I know some people who just might be able to help us. Let's give them a call now. And I think let's first ask them, what kinds of things might kids your age want to steal? Let's call them now.
What's the question? I'm probably thinking like a phone or a toy.
Sure. Different things they want, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like their iPad or something. Yeah.
That's hard. Maybe candy?
Yeah, candy.
A toy car.
Food.
Candy.
How about next we ask our friends, why do people steal?
Because they don't want to work.
Because, like, they maybe want something really bad that they do not have or something.
Mm-hmm. Because they really, really want.
Probably
because
they want something.
Because they steal because they want to have it for themselves.
All right, I think for our last question, we'll ask our Lighthouse friends, why do you think it's wrong to steal?
Because it wouldn't be fair, because if you just steal something, you're not actually paying for it. And like someone else paid for it, and you just gone. So.
Yeah.
Because if somebody really likes a toy that you steal from them, they'll start to cry and it won't make Jesus happy.
It was bad.
People are losing stuff.
Because it's not yours, it's somebody else's.
Wow, that was really great that we were able to talk with some of our Lighthouse Kid friends and be able to get their input on stealing and why kids might want to steal. Well, let's talk a little bit more about this topic. I have an object lesson that we're going to use. And let's have Clay's going to help me with that right now. All right, Clay, you're going to pretend for me. Can you pretend for me? Yeah? Okay, you're going to pretend that you're going to steal some of those beads out of that jar. But you just want one strand. Nobody's going to notice. So just take that one white one and drop it on the ground, and then you'll come take it. Just drop it on the ground. Go ahead. Oh no! Did you think they were all gonna come out like that? Wasn't that kind of crazy?
Yeah.
Clay, thank you so much for helping to show that exercise. And you know, that how those beads came out of the jar helps us to understand the concept of momentum. This word momentum, it just means that once something gets started, sometimes it can be hard to stop. So when he took out that first strand of beads, all he wanted was one strand of beads. Who was going to know? But as he pulled out that one strand and dropped it, they all came out. So just kind of showing how sometimes it can be hard once you get started doing something, especially something simple, something that's wrong. It can be hard to say, okay, this is where I'm going to stop. I'm only going to do it this one time. And that's how we bring in that concept of momentum. But that can also work the opposite way. We can try to develop good habits and momentum of giving. So that's why our street sign today is Giving Boulevard. So instead of trying to focus so much on I'm not going to steal, let's try focusing more on the positive of how can we give more. You know, there's some ways, different ways that you could be able to give. They talk about how people can give in their time, their talent, or their treasure. For you, it might look like with your time. Maybe you can help someone out to be able to get a task done that might be too hard for them to do on their own. Maybe around the house or church or at school. And then also that might look like your treasure. So with your treasure, maybe you have some money. Maybe you have a job, some allowance you get around the house, and you can give toward something that is of you think is a needy cause or something that's worth giving to. And then also your talent. Maybe you have a special gift. You have something you're really good at. Maybe you're really strong. You can help someone lift something. Or you have a really good voice and you can sing. Maybe you can use those types of talents to be able to bless people. Coloring someone a card and sending them a positive note. All of those things can be able to be a way that you can build up that habit of giving. And we're going to look at a verse that kind of helps us to remember this. 2 Corinthians 9:7. Let's go there in our Bibles. 2 Corinthians 9:7. You must each decide in your heart how much to give, and don't give reluctantly or in response to pressure, for God loves a person who gives cheerfully. God just doesn't want us to give. He wants us to give cheerfully. And so the more momentum that we can build in giving, maybe the first time you give, it might be a little reluctant, but if you keep practicing it and building up momentum, your giving is just going to flow out of you like those beads flowed out of the jar. So let's try to work on our giving and try to practice that better. I know one thing that's going on at the church right now, and maybe your parents are giving toward it, is the missions offering. We have a lot of missionaries speaking in our main services right now online, and they're talking about the ministries they're doing and also the need. And we're giving monthly and weekly from our church to be able to help those missionaries. I don't know what it looks like for you, but maybe you can give $1.50 a week. I don't know, maybe you can give more. But maybe pray about that, see how that might work for you. And maybe there's work you can do around the house to be able to help your parents. And think about maybe how you can try to be a cheerful giver. And you won't even have to worry about that temptation to steal whenever you work up and build up that habit of giving in your life. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. And just remember our big idea, we don't steal, but instead, we're going to try to give. All right, have a great day.